When a man starts out with nothing, when a man starts out with his hands empty but clean, when a man starts out to build a world, he starts first with himself, and the faith that is in his heart, the strength there, the will to build. First in the heart is the dream, then the mind starts seeking a way. His eyes look out on the world, on the great wooded world, on the rich soil of the world, on the rivers of the world. The eyes see their materials for building, see the difficulties too, and the obstacles. The hand seeks tools to cut the wood, to till the soil, and harness the power of the waters. Then the hand seeks other hands to help, a community of hands to help. Thus the dream becomes not one man's dream alone, but a community dream. Not my dream alone, but our dream. Not my world alone, but your world and my world, belonging to all the hands who build. A long time ago, but not too long ago, ships came from across the sea, bringing pilgrims and prayer makers, adventurers and booty seekers, free men and indentured servants, slave men and slave masters, all new, to a new world, America. With billowing sails, the galleons came, bringing men in dreams, women in dreams, in the little bands together, heart reaching out to heart, hand reaching out to hand, they began to build our land. Some were free hands, seeking a greater freedom. Some were indentured hands, hoping to find their freedom. Some were slave hands, guarding in their hearts the seed of freedom. But the word there was always the same, freedom. Down into the earth went the plow, in the free hands and in the slave hands, in the indentured hands and adventurous hands. Turning the rich soil went the plow in many hands, that planted and harvested the food that fed, and the cotton that clothed America. Clang against the trees went the axe in many hands, that hewed and shaped the rooftops of America. Splash into the rivers and the seas went the boat hulls that moved and transported America. Crack went the whips that drove the horses across the plains of America. Free hands and slave hands, indentured hands, adventurous hands, white hands and black hands, held the plow handles, axe handles, hammer handles, launched the boat and whipped the horses that fed and housed and moved America. Thus, together through labor, all these hands made America. Labor, out of labor came the villages and the towns that grew into cities. Labor, out of labor came the rowboats and the sailboats and the steamboats, came the wagons, stagecoaches. Out of labor came the factories, came the foundries, came the railroads, came the marts and markets, shops and stores, came the mighty products molded, manufactured, sold in shops, plied in warehouses, shipped the wide world over. Out of labor, white hands and black hands, came the dream, the strength, the will, and the way to build America. Now it is me here and you there. Now to Manhattan, Chicago, Seattle, New Orleans, Boston, and El Paso. Now it's the USA. But a long time ago, but not too long ago, a man said, all men are created equal, endowed by their creator with certain inalienable rights. Among these, life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. His name was Jefferson. They were slaves then, but in their hearts the slaves believed him too. And they silently took for granted that what he said was also meant for them. It was a long time ago, but not so long ago, that Lincoln said, no man is good enough to govern another man without that other's consent. But there were slaves then, too. But in their hearts, the slaves knew what he said must be meant for every human being, else it had no meaning for anyone. Then a man said, better to die free than to live slaves. He was a colored man who had been a slave, but had run away to freedom, and the slaves knew what Frederick Douglass said was true. With John Brown at Harper's Ferry, Negroes died. John Brown was hung. Before the Civil War, days were dark, and nobody knew for sure when freedom would triumph, or if it would, thought some. But others knew it had to triumph. In those dark days of slavery, guarding in their hearts the seed of freedom, the slaves made up a song. Keep your hand on the plow, hold on. That song had meant just what it said. Hold on, freedom will come. Keep your hands on the plow, hold on. Out of war, it came, bloody and terrible, but it came. And there was some there were, as always, who doubted that the world would end right, that the slaves would be free, or that the Union would stand. But now we know how it all came out. Out of the darkest days for a people and a nation, we know now how it came out. There was light when the battle clouds rolled away. There was a great wooded land, and men united as a nation. America's a dream. A poet says it's promises. The people say it is promises that will come true. The people do not always say things out loud, nor write them down on paper. The people often hold great thoughts in their deepest hearts, and sometimes only blunderingly express them, haltingly and stumblingly say them, and faultily put them into practice. The people do not always understand each other, but there is, somewhere there, always the trying to understand, always the trying to say, you are a man, together we are building our land. America, land created in common, dream nourished in common, keep your hand on the plow, hold on. If the house is not yet finished, don't be discouraged, builder. If the fight is not yet won, don't be weary, soldier. The plan and the pattern is here, woven from the beginning into the warp and woof of America. All men are created equal. No man is good enough to govern another man without that other's consent. Better die free than live slaves. Who said those things? Americans. Who owns those words? America. Who is America? You, me, we are America. To the enemy who would conquer us from without, we say no. To the enemy who would divide and conquer us from within, we say no. Freedom, brotherhood, democracy. To all the enemies of these great words, we say no. A long time ago, an enslaved people heading toward freedom made up a song. Keep up your hand on the plow, hold on. That plow plowed a new furrow across the field of history. Into that furrow, the freedom seed was dropped. From that seed, a tree grew, is growing, will ever grow. That tree is for everybody, for all America, for all the world. May its branches spread and its shelter grow until all races and all people know its shade. Keep your hand on the plow. Hold on.